Look at these mill tank. They're just all walking on the spot. Like, look. This Cam's not necessarily walking. Cam's just, I don't know. Cam, what are you doing? So he's feeling great about walking. We're not walking, though. More mysteries. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to episode 13, if I'm not mistaken, of Pokemon SoulSilver Chancelocke. In the last episode, we took on the fourth gym leader, Morty, and some pretty cool stuff went down. So I'm going to give you guys a couple seconds to check out the last episode, because otherwise there might be spoilers coming up. Alright, now there's no turning back. Well, there is, because now that you know. And so we're going to have a quick team recap. Meanwhile, I'll ask you guys the question of the day. Today's question of the day is, if you could create a new, unique form of evolution, what would it be, and why? Let's have a quick team recap. But yeah, be sure to smash the like button down below for us, because the audience is your support is greatly appreciated. First up, we have Cam, our admin aged level 25 Weeping Bell, holding the Miracle Seed to power that vine. We'll also rock and cut, attract, and sleep powder. Then we have Amethyst, level 25, our modern natured Espeon, rocking Shadow Ball, Confusion, Quick Attack, and Sand Attack. Then we have Diesel, level 25, our serious natured Aeron, holding the Quick Claw. She's not too fast, but she's rocking Headbutt, Iron Head, Protect, and Rock Tomb. Same moveset for like 10 episodes by now. Then we have QB, level 25, our quirky natured Ninetales now. That's one of the spoilers. Rocking Flamethrower, Will-O-Wisp, Confusion, and Quick Attack. Then we have Vicious, level 25, our gentle natured Fearow. With Aerial Ice Pursuit, Mirror Move, and Fury Attack. Then, our other spoiler incoming. Steepadrum also evolved in the last episode into a level 25 Lonely Gabite. Rocking Dragon Raid, Dragon Claw, Earthquake, and Sand Storm. And let's go. I could battle that guy. I'm gonna lead with Amethyst here. Because Amethyst has Shadow Ball and all that shit. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this. Bruh. Yeah, Espeon's special attack is like crazy. Did you see it's like 81 or something at level 25? Slowpoke. Maybe we're a little bit over-leveled, but... I mean... The gym leader's ace is 25, so I don't think we're actually that over-leveled for right now. These trainers are just scrubs. That's the only reasonable explanation I can think of for why the gym leader had insane levels, and then this trainer's just like, oh yeah, levels will be level 17, because why the fuck? Oh, okay, at least you're level 20. But you can still get bodied by a Shadow Ball, because you're a fucking Slowpoke, and I'm an Espeon bitch. Yeah, that's what I thought. Alright. 25. Alright, I can actually leave with Diesel, because... Why am I in the Pokedex? Fuck. The fuck game. I'm gonna leave with Diesel, because, you know, the sooner we can get Diesel evolved, the better. TBH. Okay, actually, you're a water trainer, so I'm gonna turn back on that, and I'm just gonna lead with our old buddy, Cam. Oh, really? Bite me, scrub. Alright, Sailor Eugene, Poliwhirl. I remember I actually once drew a Poliwhirl, like, without any guide or anything. Because I had a Poliwhirl plush. And I just thought, you know, I'd try it, because it's basically just like a little ball with legs, arms, two little eyes, and a swirl. So I tried, and I think I did a pretty good job. I unfortunately have no idea where that drawing is anymore, but... That was like a long time ago, like several years ago. Like, probably like my second year of being into Pokemon, or maybe third, I don't know. I don't even remember when I got into Pokemon. I remember it started when someone at my school gave me two Pokemon cards. They were a Magnemite and a Tangela. Both from Diamond and Pearl sets, because I'm pretty sure it was that long ago. At least when Diamond and Pearl and maybe Platinum were the newest sets. I remember, that's so stupid, I used to like write numbers on my cards so I like to keep track of them. That was a bad idea. I don't think I had any super rare ones that I actually drew on, but I had a promo Cresselia that was holographic. because of promo, so it's not that rare, but it is kind of rare now, because, you know, you don't see. Although, I remember I went to the store, slightly before last Christmas or something. Can't remember exactly when, but, I mean, I remember I saw at the stores, it was not too long ago, I saw one of the Entei tin, which I think it was Shiny Entei, I'm not sure, it was a tin and it had, and it was Entei, that's all I remember, for sure. And I was like, wow, that's old, because, like, you know, we're in, like, the X and Y days. So I thought that was kind of interesting. I think I ended up getting the Sceptile EX-10, because out of the three, I like Sceptile the most, and it turns out Blaziken and Swampert were just reprinted into those giant boxes anyways, so kind of glad I didn't get one of those now that I think about it. But I just got Sceptile because it was my favorite. See if it only had level 26. Not bad, not bad. Alright. No, I don't wanna. No, I don't wanna. No, shut the fuck up. No, I. Oh my god. You wanna fight? No. Which is exactly why I have 6 Pokemon, yes. That's exactly why, because I don't like Pokemon. That's also why I've done, like, 3 Nuzlockes on the channel. Well, this is the third one. I've posted 11 free-for-alls, 5 TCG openings, and I've played through, like, pretty much every Pokemon game since Diamond and Pearl. And I don't like Pokemon. Sure. I'm just gonna stay in on this thing, actually, because I also get static. I should be fine here. And we don't get static. Sweet. Okay. Yeah, that's a good sport right there. You don't mind losing. I swear to God. Okay, thank you. I was gonna say if you asked for my number 2. Wait, hold on. Is this? I just hop on my bike to make this a bit quicker. Lyra. What do you want? I need to answer Lyra. Just get her to shut up. Hello, this is Lyra. How are you? I wasn't along my mural by my side to load an antenna evolving to a zoomer rail. I swear I didn't think something other way. Okay. Good for you. You now are less of a scrub. And I'm pretty sure next time I see you, you're still gonna have a Meryl. So you're basically a big fat liar. Oh, it is a new route, because that was route 38, this is route 39, so we can get an encounter here. Alright, so our encounter here will be alright, let's see. We have a 3, so our third encounter on this route who will we capture? Alright, so I'm gonna have my bike to make this speed up again. Alright, so our first encounter, which is not only in Cacton, but what we could get as our third encounter, will be a Meowth. That's right! Which actually wouldn't count as Deuce, because, yeah, while we did catch a Meowth, it was, it's for trading. So we would still be able to get a Meowth. I mean, I don't know if I'd use it per se, but it would be interesting if I did use it. I mean, I just probably wouldn't use it because I have better Pokemon to to use. Well, alright, I'm just gonna knock out this Meowth real quick. So I can get the experience, so Cam can level up. That way I can have someone else up front. Alright, who do you want to put up front? I think we're gonna put Ninetales up front, just, you know, so we can have the, so we can burn and confuse what we get. So our second encounter, which is still not what we're gonna be catching, is a... Okay, I don't really want to eradicate. Besides, actually, no, I can't, because I think I already have a Rattata. That is not for trading, so this would count as species, because eradicate is the evolution of Rattata. And species, in case you don't know what species clause is, basically, if I encounter a Pokemon that is in the same evolution line as something I already have, then I don't have to catch it. Again, for the sake of variety. That counts as species, so this is perfect time to implant. Since we're all 3, this is our third encounter. So now what I have to do is I can just beat this thing up, and then whatever my next encounter is that isn't species or dupes claws, that's what I capture. Does that sound like a plan? Sounds like a plan to me. I don't know why I waste another flame thrower. I could have easily just killed this thing with a quick attack, but whatever, I'll just be spamming A. I should probably not spam A, huh? Anyways, as long as this isn't a fucking Raticate, this will be what we capture. Farfetched. Okay. Might not be too bad for a placement to Vicious, should something happen to Vicious. Okay, so I'm gonna burn you. Remember when, spoiler alert, Farfetch'd killed, Nappy's Jolteon in the SoulSilver Egglock? That was crazy. Revenge and then, like, crit revenge or something. Crits are annoying. I mean, I got a comment on one of my videos where a Pokemon died, saying crits shouldn't exist, and part of me agrees kind of with that, but part of me says no, because they added a little bit of spice, and like, yeah, I mean, I know it's annoying when Pokemon die to them, but at the same time, it's like, they're part of Pokemon. I think there are other games similar to Pokemon that where crits are a thing, like, I think Yo-Kai Watch crits, you can get like, I don't know if they're exactly called critical hits, but, you know, something along those lines. And Farfetch, I swear to God, if you don't get captured. Okay, I'm gonna try one more ball, and if it doesn't get caught, then fuck it. I'm leaving this thing behind. Fury Cutter, we can eat that up. Oh my God, so much damage. Well, I definitely can't quick attack this thing, or I'm gonna kill it. So, one more great ball, and I'm probably just gonna leave this thing behind. I don't know if I should go one more or not. Part of me wants to, just to catch thing, but part of me thinks, is that really worth it? You know, I'm gonna catch it just in case, because I don't know how good or bad Farfetch'd is, so. But I'm gonna say, if this ball doesn't catch it, then I'm just gonna run. I'm actually gonna run. I'm gonna have my finger over the run button. There we go. I couldn't really quick attack it, because did you see how much quick attack did that Meowth back there? In the last episode? Yeah. Anyways, it defeats the plant stock it carries as emergency rations. It runs off in search of a new stalk. Alright. I think so. Stalk. It carries a stalk around. Alright, it's female. It carries a stalk around. Okay, let me think of something else. Farfetch'd was the teacher in Pokemon Super Mystery Dungeon. So I'm gonna think after one of my teachers. Alright, I got this, fam. Matheson. Boom. Alright, now I'm gonna walk out of the grass so I can't. Okay, thank you. So I don't encounter anything. Alright, so that's our Route 39 encounter. Done and done. Alright, let's go. Oh. Really? Are you gonna battle me, Toro? You again? There's no need to be alert. I don't bother with wimps like you. Speaking of weaklings, there's still these zillionaires in here, and I suppose I'm taking care of a sick Pokemon at the lighthouse. Humph, boo-hoo, just let sick Pokemon go. A Pokemon that can't battle is worthless. Why don't you go train at the lighthouse? Who knows, maybe make you a bit of a better trainer. Ha! Wow, Toro, you're being a second deck right now. And again, Toro, Silverwalk, if you're walking this, I don't mean, like, wait, can we actually go? Oh, wait, can I actually go in here? I don't mean that, like, the person Toro is a dick. I mean, like, the trainer. Like, in this game. My, you know what I mean? Actually, I think Toro deserves a special shout-out because he actually made me his rival in his Dark Rising Let's Play. Go subscribe to him. If I can remember, which is not guaranteed because of my faulty memory. But if I can remember, I will try to put a link to his channel in the description below. So you guys can go check it out. Because he makes pretty good videos. He's also an emerald randomizer. And while his quality is better than mine, because he's doing it like on an emulator or something. I think he's doing it on like a touchscreen device, though, because I can see like the buttons. So, okay, we need to buy stuff. I mean, we don't need to. We should buy balls, but not right. Okay, what do you sell? What do you sell? What do you sell? What do you sell? You don't sell shit. Okay. So the same shit as every other second clerk and every other Pokemon. Okay, I have 7 grand. How many great balls can I buy with that? I can buy 12. I'm gonna buy like 6. Cause I don't necessarily need them right now. And how many Pokemon? I have 13, so I don't think I'll need any more, but in case you can never be too safe, I'll buy 5 more. Cause, you know, you can never be too safe in a Nuzlocke. True story. Anyways, I guess we'll head to the lighthouse, because that's kind of our next objective. So, yeah. Alright, do you battle? Nope, okay. It's not easy to climb because of all the trainers. I don't think it is, yeah. I mean, the trainers, I don't think are that hard, so. Anyways, I'm pretty sure this person's going to have a knocked owl, so. I'm pretty sure I remember this person, because, yeah. Okay, it's a mandatory match. I was going to say. No, because you're playing. I'm technically playing a game. Break the fourth wall. Oh my gosh. There's knocked owl. Level 22. Okay, so we're decent level. I'm going to protect you. This thing's going to go for. Oh my god. What? Okay, this kind of annoys me. Pretty much every time I go for protect, the quick claw activates. And the whole point is the quick claw is for it to activate on move like this. For it to activate when I'm using a move that's not priority. Alright, how much is this gonna do? It's super effective and it's like stab and it's 60 base power. Okay, that's good damage. And it lowers your speed. I mean, we outsped anyway, so. Confusion, we resist that and it's not stab, so that should do 0 damage. Or 6. You know, whatever. Unless it's iron. What the fuck? How do you have a full restore? Then again, you might ask the same question about Rich Boy Winston in Oris. Was level 10 Zigzagoon and used a full restore. What? Like, what? I can't even... You can't even get full restores that early in the game. I mean, yeah, you can find them, but the only way you can find them in the field that early in the game is if you are doing a randomizer and you randomize the items. And I forgot to switch. Fuck. So I know this guy can have water types. This guy has to have water types. Maybe fighting types. But that's even worse for Diesel. Long story short, sailors are bad news for Diesel. Alright, Poliwag. I could probably handle Poliwag, but I don't want to risk shit. So I'm going to Cam. Nope. You didn't even go for a water type move. What the hell? Okay, that's weird, but whatever. Catch this vine whip, bruh. Catch this vine whip, bruh. Get out of here. Get out of here. Okay, 222. I'm gonna shut up with my annoying singing. And Poliwhirl. Staying on that. Alright, level are you, Poliwhirl? Level 20, okay. I'm gonna rain dance. Alright, do you have Swift Swim? I mean, you already outspeed me, apparently, so. Didn't really matter. I don't need a Leaf Stone for a Cam. I mean, yeah, Cam only has, like, Vine Whip right now, but I'm pretty sure I looked up, Weeping Bell's level of Learn Set in Gen 4, and I don't think he gets any good grass type moves for a while. So the only way we could get a good grass type move to teach him would be to get a TM, which would be teachable to either Victory Bell or Weeping Bell anyways, so. Why does everyone here want to give you their number? What the fuck? Was that Huey? Because I'm pretty sure Huey, you're like a sailor Huey in every Pokemon game, pretty much. Anyways, I'm just gonna leave with Diesel for now until I see what the next trainer up is. And it looks like they're a Birdkeeper, so Diesel should be able to take this guy on. I'm not here to stand around and gawk. I walked up to you. Clearly I'm not just standing around. What's up with these trainers today? What the fuck? There's a level 17 Pidgey that can get demolished by an Iron Head, just because I don't want to risk the miss. Because miss will just be annoying. That's pretty much the only reason I'm going for Iron Head over Rock Tomb, because Rock Tomb has like a 20% chance to miss, and I'm pretty sure knowing my luck, I would probably miss it. Anyways, it's level 26, only 6 levels more. It's actually not too far away, because I think that. Now there's another Pidgey. Let's go into Vicious, because we can. I mean, we can pretty much go into anything on a Pidgey. Come on now. Level 15. I bet Pursuit will kill you. Lock, calling it. Dang it, so close. So close. Alright. More Pursuit, and this thing's out of here. Out of here. 75. Let's just stay in, honestly. Let me just sweep this guy with Vicious. Level 19. At least your Pidgeys are varying levels, so that makes it at least a bit more interesting, but still. You're still no more interesting than that one lady in the last episode who had 6 fucking Ghastlies. Or 5, sorry. 5, I can't count. I'm bad at math. Which is kind of evident, because I'm pretty sure I didn't do that great on the math test I had today. Pretty sure I didn't do that great. I mean, I'm not I'm good at certain branches of math, but not others. I'm good at, like, you know, the most of the simple stuff, and... Oh, it's weird. It seems like great at science. Grade 8 math, I was doing really good, and then grade 9 math, I'm just not doing as well in. Maybe it's because I had math second semester this year, so it's been over a year, but then again, still, other people are... I don't know, it's weird. Anyways, now that Diesel's level 26, I can slip someone else up front. Let's do Cam. QB. Because Amethyst should be no trouble at all to level up, because you know, Amethyst's a beast. Amethyst's a fucking beast. Alright, he was bad with me. Why do I feel like this guy can have a Growlithe? I don't know, I just feel like old man Growlithe go hand in hand. Hey! I have nothing to touch this thing. Yippee. Okay, I'm going to Amethyst. Amethyst. And I really need a water type. I mean, I know I have things that can handle, fire types, like I have Cephadrome, but I need water types for Surf. So, yeah, I mean, I can probably just catch a Pokemon and teach it Surf, but never actually use it. Or what I could do is, I could trade, like, I think I've used up all my fives, but what I could do is I could trade out one of my fives that I've already traded in, and instead bring in a water type so I can Surf. Let me know what you guys think of that idea. Okay, my thing kind of froze there for a second, so... If Growlithe HP was just suspended for a second, that's how it appeared to me, too. Not on my my DS screen. I'm looking at my tablet screen while recording, so, yeah. Mother... Stop calling me. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna battle you real quick. Real quick, Lack. And, like I said, Amethyst is getting level 26 really early, so... Now the only one I'm supposed to get to level 26 is, QB. Kyubi. Which is probably not gonna happen against a level 21 Meryl. Okay. Let's go into Cam. Alright, Cam, you can handle a level 21 Meryl. Tail whip, that's fine. Catches fine with breath. Alright, that's gonna kill because Meryl is a scrub. No, just kidding. If you guys remember my first lock on this channel, my Omega Ruby Nuzlocke, like I actually started on Google Plus, which is why it looks weird because I started, because the first episode of it was episode 14. But, yeah. Anyways. Azumarill I had on my team, and it was my highest level at the end, and yeah, it was cool. I'm really just saying, I'm just about being at this high, so I think I have something interesting to say. You wanna play with me? Okay, that's cool. Ooh, there's an item. I see an item. It's a rare candy. Ooh, I might want to save that for when Diesel's almost at the level of evolution time. It's not a bad idea. It's not a bad idea at all. Okay. A sailor. You already know who I'm going to be leading with. Alright. Look at Cam. I love how Cam moves around in the overworld. Is he really sick? Oh yeah, Amphi. Poor Amphi. Did you guys know that in this game, when Krabby falls, you would, like, actually walk sideways? Kind of cool. And in all the Pokemon Rumble games, it also walks like that, so that's kind of funny. I'm gonna just stay in, honestly. If Cam ends up being level 27 from this, so be it. You gotta do what you gotta do to keep your Pokemon. Well, I mean, I don't think a Krabby would really be able to kill QB, but, you know. You know, you never know. Might have a fucking guillotine and land it. What level do they get getting? Because I know some people won't get, like, ridiculous moves really early on. Really? Stop it, Mom. Stop. Mother, what are you doing? Mother, stop. Okay, bird dude. Then go back into QB. What was I saying, though? Fuck, I forgot what I was saying. Something to do with they walk sideways. And, oh yeah, just getting. Because I know that Pineco gets self-destruct at level 6, so that's kind of interesting. Alright, flamethrower to Spearow. I remember when I used to have a Spearow. Then it evolved into a Fearow and became 10 times better. Yeah, those days are long gone. Actually, not long gone, they're like a couple episodes gone. And ooh, you have Firo too. I can't say honestly. I don't think Firo is really gonna be able to kill QB. Catch this flamethrower, bruh. Catch this flamethrower. It's amazing that QB gets old, like, flamethrower level 24. Oh, you lived. Leer. Nah, scrub. In this case, it's a speed tie for whatever reason. Quick attack, bitch. Yeah, get out of here. Firo, get about. Get about, get about, get about. 1,039 experience, that's kinda crazy. That's kinda wild. Kinda crazy. And another Spiro. Let's go into Diesel. And take this bitch on. Let's do it. 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 Alright, so I should definitely kill this thing because it's a level 18 Spiro. Scrub. Lol, scrub. Alright, Diesel, nice experience. Nice experience. Alright. Now. I think that right here is a good enough spot to go ahead and wrap up today's episode. If you guys enjoyed, make sure to smash like button down below for us, because you already know you're very appreciated. And answer the question of the day, which is, again, if you could create a new form of, a new unique form of evolution, what would it be and why? But with that, I'm gonna bout. Thank you all once again for your support. Thank you for checking out the video, and I'm out. Peace.